Ta-da!
You're ridiculous.
So?
Little update.
Big announcement is, people have been asking when stuff will be available on the Sloppy Store.
Okay.
And you organized a pre-order.
Okay, so do you want me to say it? It will be easier.
Go through it quick.
All right, so I put together a pre-order. We do have merch on the really? We do have merch on the website. The items that are available for pre-order is a plain black zip-up hoodie with a white sloppy logo on it. Not that hoodie. No. See, this is why Matt can't do this part. So we have a zip-up hoodie with a white logo on it, then a regular, like, medium quality hoodie. It's a pullover with a white sloppy logo on it, and then we actually got high-quality hoodies because I did a poll a couple months ago and asked what people wanted, and they said they wanted the high-quality pullover hoodies. So I got Charles River micro fleece hoodies. They're really nice. They're like a different material. They kind of remind me of like the Under Armour hoodies. You're ridiculous. And there's a hidden cell phone pocket inside. Not if you have an iPhone Plus like me. It doesn't really fit. But you can put like your keys or your card inside. But this is the really nice hoodie.
So you can do cartwheels and not spill your beans.
It's actually, yeah, pretty much. It's nice because I can actually put like my credit card in it or in my like one of my key fobs. But this is actually my hoodie. So I figured I would show because I wanted to go ahead and hold it up. I don't want to scrape it on the... Yeah. Isn't it very nice? Yeah, isn't it nice?
It is very nice.
But anyways, there's three different hoodies available on the website. There are fitted hats. There are snapback hats. There are beanies. There are toolbox magnets.
All the stuff that people...
Vinyl stickers. There are shirts. They are on the website. Most items are pre-order. What we do is we do a large pre-order. It's going till the end of the week, so Saturday, Sunday, I will turn it off. Monday, I will send in the order and then allow 2 to 3 weeks for shipping. And there you go. But this is how we restock our stores, by selling items. So this is
for large stuff. It doesn't make sense to try to buy $6,000 worth of merch and sell none. So
yeah.
You ask people what they want by having them pre-order it and then fill it over time.
Yeah, so that's what we do. So we did a pre-order. So if you're interested, Matt will put the link in the description and you guys can do that. But you guys asked for it, so we delivered. We literally get messages probably every week asking us. So
classically, Matt will be told to put the link in the description and then won't for the first 2 hours. And then the viewers will remind him to apply the link and then he will. So if you're early, it might not be there.
Nice. Is that shirt for the guy that does the really nice C10s?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Anyways, here we are. So you got some goodies in the mail.
So we got some snake eater stuff.
Somebody is brapping and having a hell of a time out there.
Yeah, someone has like a third gen stuck in the mud out there. Anyway.
That sounds like a dirt bike or a four-wheeler.
I'm not sure what it is, but hopefully he's not louder than the crickets the whole time just for this filming. So Snake Eater has a bunch of new stuff. Come on in here, young lady. So this is a new style EV6, EV14 bodied. This is like Dodge and Mustang and a lot of newer import stuff. So this is a 1500 now that comes in schmedium size. And he has schmall also, but I wanted to show the schmedium because I have them. And then I gave away the smalls because that's what I do with all my YouTube and parts riches, give the parts away.
What car did they go in?
I can't even remember who I gave them to be honest. Sorry, Brad. Here is Snake Eater also sells genuine Bosch 210s. So these are flow matched LS3 height mini 210s, genuine Bosch boys. So he is now a Bosch dealer. So you can get tall, which I have the tall ones in my double intake right now. Mm. I wanted to fit them in early.
Okay.
And then these are the short ones. So these are, I was thinking about putting them in my G just for fun. But it has since been uncooperative. It's not a quad.
No, that sounds like
it's
a car.
It's not a quad.
Well, now that I'm listening to it, now that I'm closer.
Anyway, Sneaky Boy also sells hats to change your height. And if you have a complicated, let me just throw that on the ground quick. So he also sells those now. So I wanted to show everybody that. It sounds like it doesn't have most of its cylinders. Sorry, Brad, again.
You know.
Another neat thing is, recently, one of my favorite things that Brad had developed was a completely stock-looking Delphi multi-tech, multi-timer, whatever you guys want to call it. That's a completely stock truck injector, right? No, it's a SEP 600. So now he has 60-pound or 600cc or some delineation depending on your fuel pressure. He has these now. So these are drop-in truck intake injectors because ever since I said like 1500's a great middleweight injector, he has sold out of them every 30 seconds when he puts them in stock. And not to make fun of a bunch of you, but there are like cam-only gasoline guys making 400 horsepower with 1500s.
Yeah.
And a lot of times they struggle with their ECU because it can't lower the minimum pulse width to appropriate a 1500cc injector. So now this is a possibility. So these four, why are there only four, you might ask? They're going in the Kia. These are the ancillaries for the Kia. Yeah.
So for everyone asking what's going on with the Kia, you're still working on it.
Yeah,
but keeping it drivable, so.
It's because this thing's torn apart, right?
You know, I just have to comment how much nicer it looks without the wheels.
Yeah.
It looks so much better. And
I
then somebody
in the woods and the deer ate them.
Somebody was like, those are from an SN95, and I was like, that's why I hate them.
It doesn't matter. They're just, yeah. And then these are also SEP 600s, 60-pounders. So these are, we're going to put these in the Wack Shack truck, the Colorado.
Oh, nice.
Because I had 850s laying around, and Wack Shack is using like a nil percentage of 850s. So just for fun, we want to put these in, get them running well, show people usage on gas, ethanol, all of the regular full-on data, give away the tune file, of course, and show people how well the 60s work versus the 850s. So yeah, we have all those.
When did all these arrive? I don't even remember seeing the boxes show
like
up.
Like a day or two ago.
Oh, you must have got them before I saw the box.
I think it was the same day your studs came.
Oh, yesterday.
So yeah, it was right then. I got the box and everything. And then Snake Eater also has these cool... He sells these in every different size. 325, 364, 293. Obviously, this is a... It's a takeoff of the old school
Turn
logo.
Turn the other one around.
Oh, these are just, he just throws these in.
Yeah, there's.
Yeah. So there's 325. 293 is a 4.8. This is a 6 liter. So, yeah. Pretty cool.
Yeah.
So there's all that available. We're going to be testing them. Other than that, I really like the, like these Delphi-style drop-ins. Mitch has had them in his car for like 2 years now. He has 1,000s. He's going low nines on pump E. And the hilarious thing is when people talk smack, let's just go into this quick.
Oh boy.
People are like, Sneak Eaters won't open over 60 PSI. Mitch, at idle, he has a 4303 into a stock fuel pressure regulator. 4303 pump into a stock Gen 3 truck fuel pressure regulator. It runs 105 PSI at idle.
You're lying, aren't you?
And they idle fine.
You're lying, aren't you?
His fuel
Matt
pressure,
Happel, why are you lying?
His fuel pressure doesn't fall to 60 pounds until he starts making decent power and boost, and then it kind of hovers around and goes back up. So his fuel pressure goes from 100 to 60 during a hit at the track. Yeah, anyway, they work fine, and they have worked fine for 2 years, and he street drives it and does burnouts and posts.
Yeah,
them
he just went to the car meet I went to on Sunday.
Yeah. And, you know, we fire it 60 times on a track weekend and bomb out. It was high nines, now it's in the low nines. And it's going to get a turbo soon from Mr. V-Ren. That's not how you say it, I'm just exaggerating.
I know.
It was just his birthday, do you guys know? Anyway. We're done here.
Alright.
Buy some hoodies if
you're
you want them.
Yeah,
if.
Yeah.
If you ask.
Don't push merch, don't be a weirdo. Don't be that guy.
Unsubscribe, thumbs down, do whatever you gotta do to
there
make
you
this.
Go.
If you're having a bad day, do whatever you gotta do,
and
guys.
Matt and I are actually gonna work on one of my videos. I went to a meet this over the weekend, and I just videoed all the cars, but I didn't really talk. I was really tired, and I just I was just not in the mood. So Matt and I are going to actually sit there and watch the meet together and talk about all the cars. So I think it's going to be pretty entertaining to see Matt's initial reaction to some of the vehicles that were there.
So. Will it be I comment and you laugh?
No, it's going to be both of us.
Okay.
But there is no holding you back. How do you feel about car meets, Matt? That meme that you put on Instagram? That was pretty amazing.
Which one?
The whole car meets I want to go to, how about not? Or, it was funny.
Wow. Yeah, none.
But I think it's going to be pretty
funny.
Even
if I organize, people will be funny because I'll probably organize one eventually one day. We talk about it constantly. It's difficult to do. And I don't want to.
You don't want to go to your own car
and
meet.
I'll be like, it's cool, and I'll see people, and I'll be like, ugh, what are all these people doing here? And you'll be like, you invited them, and I'll be like, why did I do that? Why? What kind of masochist invites all these people?
Well, anyways, where are you at with that thing? You're just pulling stuff off?
Yeah, I just started ripping everything apart, and then, I like AJE stuff, but a lot of people are like, AJE is not good for street drive. Yeah. And I'm like, okay, so I think I've converted myself to Team Z, so I might reach out to them, or I might just say, I'm tired of reaching out to people. At this point, I have so much stuff I want to get rolling, I'll just call Team Z and be like, this is what I got, this is what I want to do, and I'll just buy it all.
These are my goals.
I don't need a discount, so I just need the parts now. And then I'm going to...
Is that the last stuff that you
need?
I'm
going to pull the fenders, and you're going to sawzall the front end off the car.
Ooh, sawzall? Where's the plasma?
You could use that, but it's harder to keep a straight line.
Well, yeah, I know that, but I mean, is there anything that needs some plasma work? It's been a long time.
We could just plasma a bunch of stuff before we cut anything. Okay. But essentially, you mark a line with tape, and you slice the whole thing, because I'm going to do a tube K... tube A's, coilovers, and a tube front end.
Okay, well...
Team Z sells a thing where you cut the whole front end off.
Yeah, you were explaining it last night.
Tubing. So you can do copious turbo things.
Okay. So you can put your twin boys in
it's
there.
It's just easier at that. I just feel like... I've thought about staging it all, but I'm like, you know what? While it's all apart, while I cut all the brake lines out of this thing, should we show them quick?
Yeah, we can. I'm excited.
What kind of a-hole puts brake lines all over? Like, I'm used to working on older Foxes... And I'm like, why are the brake lines going... Here, come this way, children.
Show me the way. I'm excited for the sawzall. I didn't know that that was going to be my debut.
That's a thing. Like, I think he says you measure...
No,
like,
I didn't know that you were deciding that I was doing it.
16 and whatever. Well, why the hell not? No offense. And then you just go, well, you take the fender off first, and then you go, bah, all the
or
way down.
Or you go, bloop.
Or you just cut the whole fender off, too, because it's a Fox body. Who cares? These are the brake lines.
Matt, the paint.
These are the brake lines.
The paint.
Look at this. These are the brake lines from the master cylinder. So I guess the a-holes didn't have enough room to put this gigantic ABS block anywhere. So they ran all the brake lines to here and all the way back out and all the way, I don't know. So all of it's going to go. And I'm probably going to pay one of my friends to come over here and do brake lines while I sit in the corner and cry. Because if there's anything in the world I hate more than brake lines, it's...
Is that why you had the ones down on the truck?
Yeah. Because honestly, I'll crimp. Like, I can do a certain amount of things, obviously, but brake lines is something that just doesn't cooperate with me, and I know it, so I just give up.
We'll get you some Kit Kats. You'll sit
just
in
like,
the corner.
Yeah,
drink some Coke Zero.
Fairmont 5, when Michael Wisswesser, Matt Wisswesser's brother, came over and basically crimped all the lines
for me. I forgot about that, yeah.
He had like a super expensive hydraulic brake line crimping tool because I would buy a brake line and crimp it and it would be offset and leak every time. I flared an end like 17 times with 5 different flare
tools.
Should
I pay Mitch to give you a class on how to do it?
I think Mitch probably has a very nice brake line tool considering their business and amount of vehicles.
Well, they need brakes for plow, so there you go.
I was probably going to cut all the brake lines out of the car because they are all over and the block needs to come out. It's getting thrown in the trash.
And we're going to sell this motor, right? I heard you can get it like $100 for
that
it.
That one guy, I was like, I'm going to throw the engine out.
No.
But Cameron wants the trans. And some guy's like, oh, for $100, someone got the engine and trans. I'm like, well, Cameron will give me more than that just to give him the tranny, even though I'm going to ship it to him for nothing. Oh. And then we'll see if someone wants the engine for $50.
Well, I'll post it online. I don't care.
We'll see. But I don't want someone that's like, I'd rather just take it to Craig Kishing and be like, give me $1. Or give me a hubcap or a wheel or a piece of exhaust pipe.
Just shake my hand, buddy.
Yeah, that's the whole thing, right? Like, if he can sell this and use it, and I can get a piece of 4-inch exhaust tubing one day, that's how we work, so.
What a car.
Yep, so I started tearing everything out. I took the whole front end off.
At least I never have to drive it with the V6 in it again. That's terrifying. I sent Matt a text message when we let our friend borrow it, and I was driving home, and I was like, just please don't let me die in a V6
I don't
Mustang.
Want to die in a V6 Mustang.
It was
so sad and so true.
Yeah.
And then I go to loosen the thing off the power distribution thing. I wanted to keep this, and the whole bus broke. So the whole fuse box seems like it broke. Or it bent enough that it's probably not good
Don't you
anymore.
Have those new fancy boxes that you can put in?
Well, I have that entire race pack smart wire.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
But it's
not
the factory fuse panel, so I have to cut and find whatever integrates to this.
Well, it's a good thing you love to wire.
But all that's got to go anyway because I'm going to...
Move it.
This is going to get cut.
Yeah.
This isn't going to exist. Nothing in front of this is going to exist anymore. So this all has to go anyway. And then I'll probably cut the AC condenser lines here and keep everything so we can refit it.
So somebody asked online, and they asked what your goals are for the car, and I just thought just burnouts and ice cream, but I mean,
essentially, we were just going to build kind of a nice car, and then my sponsors went ape on me, like, in the beginning of 2020, and I didn't even have time to finish this with the other cars we had, yeah. And I have, like, the short block over there and everything else, and then my buddy at Holly... is like, we'll make a list and get you the rest of the stuff now that you're started. And I was going to buy all Team Z everything front and back. But I said to a couple people it'd be funny for this to go a high 7, but depending on how heavy it is, it's not out of the realm of possibility. But if it's on the heavier side, it'll be like, I always said it'd be funny to show up AC power windows, like just bark a low 8 and go home.
I'd like to keep the interior because I'd like to be able to put our son in it.
It's exactly the same.
Because I want to be
able
to...
Other than it might have...
Because it would be fun to take little man out.
Other than it might have party pipes, it's going to be the same car.
Well, party pipes.
I'm probably going to do bullhorns out of the nose because who wants...
Oh, you're going to do a Frank Soldridge?
Part of me wants to do under the K tailpipes, and then the other part of me does not probably have the... Once it's running and I need to build an exhaust, maybe I'll do both. Like, I'll have bullhorns and I can bolt on, or I can do twin loud valves. I mean, the owner of loud valves is super cool. Every time I build a car, he's like, whew! I just get stuff in the mail and I'm like, what's this? He doesn't even say anything most of the time. I just get stuff. He's super cool. So it would be cool to have, like, loud valves. Or, like, most of the time, a 3-inch twin turbo car isn't going to be loud. Really, so who cares? But 3-inch tailpipes is easily manageable in a car like this, but I don't know. I think these cars look pretty good with twin horns out the nose.
It just makes me think of Frank Soldridge with the
And then,
with
what's
the
funny is they're not that loud and they're not that smelly, especially on E. It doesn't really... So there's no particular goal in mind other than like putting on a whole bunch of expensive stuff and... it's not normally something I would do, but if people are... I like to explore, obviously, expensive things and try to find the value or show you guys the value in it, right? And you can make that... There's plenty of stuff where I'm like, this is expensive, but I like it. It's cool. So I'll buy that and spend nothing on other things. So right. It's like an experiment in excess, and then...
You're just trying to have fun.
And it's also just going to be like 100% streetcar, and if it goes fast, it goes fast. And if it really struggles to put down power with, like, a BS street suspension, I don't care. Like, it's still going to go fast.
Yeah.
I figure the turbos and everything I have will do probably over 1,300 rear wheel, but I'll probably quit at 11 so I don't rattle my sleeves out of my motor and my cool daily-ish car. So we'll see.
All right, well.
That's it. Other than that, ask more questions.
Yeah, ask more questions in the comments below.
If you want, and then we're going
to
spend some
time. I love how you have to add if you want.
Yeah, I feel, you know.
I know. All right, well, everyone have a nice day. Say bye.
Bye-bye.